So this was the problem. Like we have discussed for the mode problem, right? And I think I have mentioned that D, the variable which is mode removed by the predictor, means actually this meaning is that it is bitten by some animals. Okay, so the moth which we are removing, they may be eaten by some other animals only. Okay, so make sure that that is the meaning of predictor. And I think rest we have already seen. So let's see the next problem. So I think we have also written the summaries and everything for the this data. Question number 3. So, and this is the question number 3. Correct? This was the output. Electrostaticity we have checked, and we have found that do not, that means variances are equal. So here you can see the variances are equal, that means there is no heteroscedasticity exists, as well as the using normal test we have found that it is normally distributed. That means condition is satisfying. But if you see the R square value, your R square values turns out to be only 5%. Okay, so actually before fitting the model, we have I think once the model is, once you have created this model, like this lm y is equal to x plus dummy variable, we should check for assumption. We should not go directly like going for the summary. We should always go for first checking this plus go with actual I can say, I will say in terms of application, when you actually, if you have a data, so the what is the beginning, so the first step to start, once you have created this model, the first step you must check for the plot. Don't directly go with summary, means don't perform directly ANOVA and ANCOA. Okay, we should check plots. It's like if you have the bivariate data, so first we check for scatter plot. I think if you just remember in FIBSE, we have a chapter correlation, and when we have the bivariate data, then first we need to check for their scatter plot, and from that scatter plot we find some pattern. And based on that pattern, we are trying to calculate the R value. Means we should just check the relation, whether the what kind of pattern is exist between the two variables. And then we go for the calculations part, and then we go for the regression and so on, like that. Okay. So those things will be like, that means that's all the basic assumptions of that particular variable. So make sure that this is something like we have done it first estimation, and then all assumption, that is actually totally wrong. I'm totally disagree with this all. But now for a being, you have given see, as I mentioned, the university has given this solution only. Okay, so that's why I'm referring this one. I'm this basically this practical I'm thinking first time. Okay, so but as per my concern, you must, not for this data, but when you go for outside for the jobs and maybe going for the placements, always you deal with the data first, looking as a basic assumption. If basic assumption satisfying, then only you can go for the fitting part and summary part and rest testing part. Okay, so just keep remember, this is all concepts which is maybe the beyond of let's go to the example number 4. Let's share the example number 4. So we have a auto MPG Excel file, and to identify which variables are influencing the miles per gallon, that is your MPG, fuel consumption of a car. Okay, so which are the factors most important as per miles per gallon? That means how much average you can say given by which are the factors? So that factors we need to identify. Okay, now you can see here, these are the variables. These are the variables, and even the variables is also given in terms of. Now, if you see here this problem, in this problem they have directly given the variable name, but they have not mentioned whether it is continuous and whether it is discrete. Okay, but in this problem they have mentioned everything, like MPG, that is miles per gallon, it is continuous data, means your Y is continuous. Then cylinder multi-value discrete. See, it is multi-value discrete. Then placement continuous. Means displays horsepower, weight, acceleration, model year, okay, origin, car name, etc. So these are the basically types of variable. And I think I have mentioned, I was talking about a little bit concepts of whether when do you apply multiple regression analysis. That is a very important. Until unless the all variables should be continuous, okay, dependent and independent, both variables should be the continuous. Then only you can apply. You can go for MLR or regression analysis. Otherwise, you won't be apply that. Then we have some other technique. That was ANCOVA. Maybe it is logistic regression. Okay, like that. So there are so many other concepts are there. But if you see this all variable type. I didn't see the solution. I didn't see the solution. As per my concern, they should not assume that model year. Model year is, I think, no requirement. Multiple value discrete, no requirement. But let's see what actually this particular syntax what they have given. Now the data consists of 398 records characterizing the various types, various car types. So we have different car types. And for each car type, the following attributes are provided. So that is your MPG measured for each car model to test the performance in 1982. So basically they are considering one factor, which is MPG. Mainly mileage will be very important. Okay, we are that depending on car mileage. Okay, how much that particular miles per gallon it works, and the numbers of the engine cylinder, how many cylinders are there, then cylinder displacement in cubic inch display, means it's like whether it is in cubic type, whether it is like horizontal type, and there are different types of displacement is there. Then engine power, what is the power, means they have described this all variable in little bit what is meaning. Okay, that this data, this information is also available in your maybe if this data is inbuilt, then it will be there in our R. Otherwise, you must read this information and get. But our task is to be just understand this variable conceptually. Okay, and what it means. See, if I ask you weight, means it is understood. It is understood that the weight of maybe car, something like that. Okay, model year means what is the manufacturing of that particular car, which is the year. Okay, that is all basically means you can understand the questions, I think. Okay, so that is the all thing very important. Okay, so let's see the solution for this. So we can go to the directly R. Question is going for R. Let's try them for R code for this one. So we have a question number 4. So basically, question number 4, we are interested on MPG data. Okay, so auto MPG data. So let me import the data. Look at a screen. Please look at a screen. See, all procedures and everything, they are all same. There is not much things are there, but let me see the what exactly concepts they are using. So we have a, let's see this, whether this data is an NPG data. So I hope you can able to see the data actually. See. So if you just write, you can see, you can scroll it. So this is all names data. This is the origin, year, acceleration, weight, etc., etc. Okay. So let's take the name of that. So you can view the data. So view, I think that view part is already there. So I will just selecting that particular data set name, let's say MP. So MP means we have a auto MPG data, which is equal to, I'll say this data set. Okay, let me just view this data first. See, once you type few letters, automatically that data set will be the automatically loaded. So you may come across this value. Just run it, and you can see automatically going to the next tab. That means that syntax is working. So now I'm coding that particular data set into AM. Okay, so AM is my auto MPG data set. So AM is equal to auto data set. So I'm just assuming, because always instead of writing MPG, I can use the AM method. And I will execute. So here my question is, I wanted to know which are the factor influencing by MPG. Okay, so that is my task. Okay. So now what is the next task? You can check with names. What are the names are there? So you can come across the names. Like you can see ...... 1 MPG cylinder displacement. Acha. Now I'm just asking one question, whether you are remember or not, I don't know. I just want to see what are the characteristics of this MPG, whether MPG will be continuous, discrete, etc., etc. So what could be the command for that? Yes, anyone? I just wanted to know what is the command for checking whether there will be continuous, discrete, numeric, etc., etc. So what could be? Come on. Yes. Okay, so one can use string data. So that particular data will give the string command. So once I type string and I put the my data set name, should I give me string data? So you can clearly see here which are the number, which are the variable is numeric. I hope you can able to see the console window. Sorry, see the console window. MPG is numeric, cylinder is numeric, displacement is numeric, horsepower is character. Even it is number, you can see here, even it is number. And I told you whenever there is double dot, that means actually that is the character. We always write alphabets in form of double dot, double quoted, right? Double quote. So that means your horsepower is character. So we cannot run it until unless we convert it as numeric. Okay. So here is a even the name also you can see, but I think name we are not dealing with the name because name will be excluded I think from the picture. So if we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Even the name is also correct, but is the name is required or not, that we will see. But definitely horsepower we have to convert it to the numeric. So we have the command for checking for characteristics for numeric. So one can go for summary. Let's check the summary of AM, let's say from 2 to 9, and start and you can get the summary of your entire data. Can you see MPG data, miles per gallon, we have minimum number, maximum number, first quartile, etc. Similarly, second quartile for cylinder, displacement, horsepower, can you say? It is not calculated because it is characteristics. Similarly, you can say weight, etc. Okay. So you can see here name, the 2 to 9 means I'm not taking the first one, I think. First variable, because that is the all about your serial number, I can say. And even the last one, which is the name, so which has no meaning. If you just take the summary of your you can say auto MPG data, you may come across this out. Okay. So that summary says that horsepower is basically characteristics. So that the first thing is that we need to convert that variable from factor to integer. So I have used command string. Okay. So that command, basically string command, give us to know about structure of data. That my data is data is numeric or character. So that string command always gives the structure of the data, how this data is, whether it is numeric or whether it is, that means it is quality or it is quantity. So we found that the horsepower is discrete, we can say character. So we need to convert it, that data, into integer value, I can say numeric value. Okay, so how to convert that data? I think I have given the command. If you have remember, I have given the command. So what we have to do, conversion of variable, let's say AM we need to change that AM and this horsepower equal to as dot numeric as dot numeric. Now from where you are converting that? So we are converting that data as a character. Now it is converted to numeric. Okay, it is converted to numeric. So as character in bracket, we have AM data of dollar sign of that particular variable horsepower. Okay, so this actually converted, because as dot numeric, that means it is converted to numeric. Since it was character, now it is converted to numeric. So if you just run this, what it's saying? It should work. Let's write down the class of AM underscore horsepower. See, now it is numeric. Now if you just again execute this string part, now you check whether all are coming numeric. See, horsepower is now coming numeric. So that means that I have converted my all the data which was character, which was qualitative, into quantitative. So once I done it this, I can now go ahead with my model. But see, as I mentioned, in horsepower the variable 6 is missing, denoted by question mark and replaced by mean value 10. Okay, now if you see the data here, is that any value is missing? Can you see here missing value? This value is missing. How do you know? So for that you need to check the data. Even in summary also it will give some message. So if you see your data properly, I'm just sharing the data set, so we can be able to see that. You can see this data. So you may get this data, and here you can see, if you just see the clearly, except that value and even this value, or else maybe you can check for this some data. Can you see here? Some data is missing here in horsepower. So if your data is missing, then what we can do in that scenario? You cannot apply the regression, because this is called missing analysis. So we need to just convert this data. You have to replace this particular question mark with their mean. We need to replace that question mark with their mean. Okay. So that we have to do in certain cases. Okay, so for that, what we have to do, we have to, so wherever is the missing value is there, we need to change it by their mean. Okay, we need to change it by their mean. So for that, we need to write a code for the same. So I can say, see whether you understood or not this one. You do one thing, you just find out again summary of the data. What is mean is coming now? Mean is coming 104.5. So I need to change, I need to in the power in the horsepower variable 6, missing values are denoted by Z and replace them by their integer value is 104.5. 104.5. Because this is the missing value. So I'm replacing that missing value to 104.5. Since I don't have the complete data that we have studied, na, missing something, the maybe some kind of analysis you have seen. If data is missing, then how we can do, right? Like that. So whenever it is missing, we always replace it by their mean value. Now, how to replace it, that value will be by their mean. That code is here. You check whether you can understand this code or not. So I'm going to modify a little bit code and let's see whether it will run or not. So I have my AM data. Okay, let me just write it down. What is that? Importing, inputting the missing value in the horsepower by mean. So AM horsepower, if else is, see, whenever we write for NA, that means your data is missing. NA means your data is missing. So if I'm just putting the conditional condition on that my data set, if else it is missing in my data set AM, then I have to round the mean of my data set. See, now they are saying it is round, okay, so they will round it around some value. And not means that we are not removing, we are not removing that, okay. So RM means removing. Removing is true, and we have this data set under. So it will create me the new data set. So around this value, I'm substituting. Around means it can be approximated to one or two digits, or it can be take approximate 104. No problem. Let we can we will verify the answer. We will verify whether it is matching or not. So if I'm executing this command for like replacing that particular data set in my AM, is it work? Let's see. So this is working. Command is working, that means. Okay. Now suppose you want to check it. Suppose you want to check it, your AM now, and so data set AM. Let's say that how it is now. How it look like? Is that replaced that data set? Can you see question mark so far? I think it is replaced by. But which is the value actually? According to me, it was 1C. You can see 104.
You can see 104. It's rounded to 104 because all remaining data are in the form of rounded 225 like that, right? So it is rounded to 104. See, 104. So this is the way you have to convert your data. If data is missing, then you have to convert it. You have to convert it to you can replace it that with missing value. Yes, any question? You can check if you want to check missing value, whether in your data set missing value is there or not. What is the command for checking the missing value? I think don't remember actually this time. Just try for is any function. Is any function? I think that will work. Is any function is there? Yeah. Is any function am? But the whether in my data set whether the it is like missing values there or not? See, it will show you the this syntax like this. So we need to understand this data. Horsepower. See the horsepower. Okay, it will not. It will now. It will not show because I have already converted. I have already converted the data. Maybe by missing to given value, right? But if you check for whether missing value is there or not, so you may check this for this one for missing value. I think it will work. Okay, but you may just check it out. Is that okay? Any other question? I don't understand this, sir. Missing values. It when you do the summary, it was showing that. I don't know. If I do this summary, is that showing six data is missing something? No, I think it will not show you until unless you run this code. If you run this code, then only you can able to see the missing value, or maybe it is given in a form of. True false. Okay, so you have to check this. It will you have to check with that I can say using that command. So I'm replacing that value by 104, not 104.5, because it is rounded, and one can view that value. Okay, any questions so far? Yes. So from where I started from my data set am. I check their name, I check their string, whether it is continuous, whether it is numeric. Then I check their summary also. Summary means just understanding the data, but as on the basis of string I found that my horsepower is basically a character. So already I have mentioned I cannot perform ANOVA because it we have all variables should be, if it is continuous then only I can. So I need to convert that particular horsepower into numeric. So numeric, so as dot numeric, and since it is character, so as dot character am horse. Okay, then you can check the class of that horse, whether it is now it, whether it is turning to numeric and or it is still character. So you can found that this is coming numeric. And one can see here, if you see the data, and you need to check also missing value. Okay, so you want to check first whether is missing values there or not. We didn't see in any cases there is missing value or not, but I think that you can always proceed and check it. Okay, so if you checking this particular data set whether it is it having the new missing value, then you need to replace that value by their around mean. You have to replace it by their mean. So in that case we have to use this command. So if else there is a numeric value, if else there is a numeric or not numeric missing value, you can substitute according to their mean. Okay, and then you can view your data set, and once you can view your data set, it automatically all missing value will be replaced by your mean. So this was the things we done so far. Now what else we can do? So as I mentioned, as a statistician, our task is to understand the data, and if I'm applying the MLR, we should always go with the first checking some plots and etc. Okay, so this is the way we have to always check first of all, then only we can go ahead with all doing our, since we have done already all the problems. But as per my knowledge, we can always go with the first plot. Okay, so I can go with the, I can say going with the first of all, I can say bivariate plot. So let's plot it, let's plot and see the visualization first. So I need to do some bivariate analysis and visualization. Okay, so for that we need to check first correlation. Okay, so we need to check just correlation, and in that correlation just find out the correlation of from AM data set, we have AM data set and 2:9, but this is the column, right? 2:9, just check whether you are getting the correlation between. So if you just type correlation, will show you the entire correlation summary. This is called correlation summary. So what this correlation summary gives, this says whether you have a relationship between, I know MPG versus MPG is one, agar aap variable same variable ka correlation same variable variable ke correlation se nikalenge to your answer turns out to be one, right? That is only one. But if you check the correlation between cylinders and MPG, you may say there is a strongly negative correlation between these, I can say MPG versus cylinder, even displacement, even horsepower, weight. Can you see? Yes, there is a correlation exists between these. Are you getting? So this is actually things we have to always check first of all. This is a very very important concepts which you have to always follow. Okay, after that, if you not understand this is like the numerical value, one may go for plots. That's called correlation plots. Okay, so you draw the correlation. Is that plot is coming? Okay, you need to install when you want to draw the correlation plot, you need to install some package, I think. So install dot packages in bracket, I can say, is there is package like correlation something. It's not showing. So just plot this.
Parallelogram.
Sorry?
Parallelogram.
I didn't try out, but is that core plot something there is package? Okay, it is executing. Let's see whether it will run or no. I don't know, but let's see. Maybe you may. So it's downloading. Anyways, let's see. So you can call library. You can call core plot instead of just calling that. Just call that. Okay. And now you plot it. See, you can got it. Can you see a core plot? So when before I was stopping, I was typing the core, I'm not getting this command, but now it is showing, means it is exist. So core plot of what? Correlation. So correlation. And you can actually see the visualizations between the data. Can you see in the right hand side? I don't know whether you can able to see it, but we need to understand this data very conceptually. And I will just I don't know how they are interpreting. I'm just sharing the screen for the same. Let's try to understand this plot. Can you understand this plot? Or if anyone can explain, no problem. Yes, can you understand this particular diagram? Actually, it's like look like a diagram. It's not shows the proper. I think if I give such a plot, nobody can explain anything regarding that. But what I can understand, MPG versus MPG is one. Means wherever there is a this blue circle, I guess I can say it is one. Cylinder versus MPG. There is some relation. Means wherever you can say where it is dark, it's very dark. It's like there is a strong relation. Wherever and when a circle is very big, that means strong relation is exist. Strong relation is exist. Okay. And wherever is the, you can say small circle, that means relation is there but not very strongly. And wherever, I think wherever is dark there is a negative, and wherever is there's a light it will be positive. I think it's like that. It's like, okay, so we can even cross check with the data. We can even cross check with the data. So that screen I'm sharing. So if you just see the now data, okay, one can go with the data. See, so wherever is a what I mentioned, wherever is a dark data, that is negative correlation. Dark and big, it is negative. But light and small, it's smaller. Light color is there, and but smaller data, that means there is a positive correlation. You can see here it is light color. I think the I can say the brown color, which was brown or red, what you can see, I think it is brown. So that brown color is basically or I can say very dark. If it is very very dark, it representing the strong relation. Okay, and if it is a very very light, it is representing also very I can say strong but negative. But if it is not relation, that means it's going to be very light and small. It's like how you interpret your data. It's like how you interpret your data. So at right extreme, the scale is given with different colors. Acha, it is showing a scale is given. I can't see that scale. I can't see the scale here. Okay. So you may go with that scale. Yeah. Correct. If you see that scale, very dark will be one, and very again dark will be minus one. And if it is same thing I mentioned, but maybe in terms of circle, okay. In terms of circle, but circle is smaller. That means your correlation becomes smaller. Are you getting? Means one can interpret like that. Okay. Anyways, you have to just understand whether there is a strong relation exists or not. That is my overall interpretation. So we have checked the condition that there is relation exists. There is an relation exist. So now, if there is a relation exist, we can go for regression. We can go for regression. So we will now fit the regression. See, what I mentioned, we have a data. We checked there some condition, maybe not all condition, which is not possible. Some condition like plots and correlation, then we go for regression. Means if there is strong relation, then only we can go for the model. So we will now create a model. Okay, so we have to do model building. So how to do the model building? So model building, multiple linear regression between the our dependent variable and independent variable is, we have to now consider the model. Okay, we have to consider the model. So what is the model now? So I have to give the model. What is that model? How we are writing that model? I think it was like a model like that. It was like the model. Okay, so we'll fit the model. So let's say fit, or I will say model. Model is equal to LM in bracket. LM in bracket. I will see L. Is it showing? Not showing. AM dollar sign MPG. This is my dependent variable. Tilde sign. Then we need to consider the data swarm. AM dollar sign cylinder plus AM dollar sign next variable displacement plus AM dollar sign horsepower plus AM dollar sign weight plus AM dollar sign weight is done acceleration AM dollar sign year AM dollar sign origin. Okay, so you can check how many variables are there. So this is dependent variable 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. There are 7 variables are there. That means there are 7 betas are there, 6 betas. Yeah, means including beta naught, you may total 8 variables. Means 7 variables are there. One will be beta naught, so it's going to be your
data is equal to data. See, this is one way. This is the one way where you are not supposed to be write like this. So I will just execute this model. Let me execute this. So you can see the model is showing, and one can get the summary of the model. So you can get this summary of the model. Now the same thing, this is also written as in another way. Model, let's say model 1 is equal to LM, but here we need to write that you need to write this variable. तो ये वेरिएबल है, तो वेरिएबल में अगर आपने गड़बड़ कर दिया लिखना तो मॉडल आपका बराबर नहीं आएगा. इसलिए जनरली मैं रेफर करता हूँ कि आप कि ये वे में ही जाइए. सिलेंडर्स प्लस डिस्प्लेसमेंट प्लस हॉर्स पावर प्लस और क्या है वेट प्लस एक्सेलरेशन प्लस ईयर ओरिजिन एंड कॉमा डेटा इज इक्वल टू एम. I think it also works. Check. Displacement is not found. मतलब इधर आपने स्पेलिंग का मिस्टेक किया हुआ कुछ तो. Displacement. See the spelling.
Sir, acceleration का भी spelling wrong है.
हाँ, तो वो मतलब मैं that's why ना I refer always going with this. वो क्या होता है मालूम है? अपने को ज़्यादा सोचने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. Model data set में हमारे पास already variables are there. And we need to just pick up the variable. But if you going with this, in that scenario, it may wrong. You may come across the spelling mistakes, and there may be chance. Or anyways, आपको output करेंगे तो automatic को दिखाएगा कि किधर mistakes हो रहा है. देखो, अभी यहाँ पे दिखाया नहीं. मतलब आपने जो variable का नाम लिखा वो सब बराबर है. और आप summary फिर से निकालो तो आपको summary of model one फिर से मिलेगा, which is going to be same. See, this is 0.946, you can see above. 0.9. You'll be get the same answer using this model, or you can use this model. Okay, so both you can work, no problem. Whichever you feel better, whichever you feel secure, and it will not like you cannot do the mistakes. You can go with that model. There is no problem at. Okay, these are three like, but usually I refer the second one. This one, because it is like for me it is safer, means I without the any mistakes I can go ahead with that. Okay, so once I have created a model, I need to check. See, model ban gaya apna, matlab maine plots dekha, plots se mujhe malum pada ki there is a strong relation between the variables, so I can create a model. Okay, once I have create a model, what would be the next task? I can check the all like whether hetero what do you call? I can go with the R square value, and one can check the model is good fit or not, as we did in the previous case. Now our problem is solved. मतलब अभी अपने को क्या करना है, अपने को check करना है कि होमोस्केडास्टिसिटी है कि नहीं, मल्टी कोलिनियरिटी है कि नहीं, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. दैट वी कैन आई थिंक वी कैन, एवरीवन कैन चेक. सो यहाँ पे मैं क्या चेक कर सकता हूँ, आई विल यूज दैट कमांड एम प्रो ने बाबू को दिक्कत ही नहीं है. this diagnostic plot says, diagnostic plot is basically tell you some idea about that plot. So let's say plot of your model. Okay. The figure is too large. Acha, figure is too large. You cannot able to see it. Okay. So basically this diagnostic plot suggests that the model which you have created, it's like a correlation plot. It's like your correlation plot, and one can check that plot according to the see, as we did here in the previous cases, we have checked for the plots, right? We have checked with the plot. So same thing, you can go with this plot. Okay. What is next one? One can check with the letters plasticity also. Okay. So for that we need to just check for BP test. To check for homoscedasticity. For homoscedasticity, we can check for BP test. BP test is not showing. So BP test is not, that means you have to call library. Okay, so library LM test. So until L is not called LM test, means you need to call it. Then BP test will show you. So if you just say BP test of model, that's it, work on. See, so what the BP test says, the data is homogeneous or data is heterogeneous. So we found that the p-value which we obtained is lesser than the 0.0. Means I may say that we are going to reject H-null. That means the data is heteroscedastic. Means it is, the variance is not equal. You are rejecting H-null. No? That means it is, the variances are not equal. The variances are not equal. That means heteroscedasticity exists in our data. Now one can check their multicollinearity also. The multicollinearity we will see in the next class. Like in next unit we have that all multicollinearity. Okay. And one can check with the what is that Shapiro test? This one. Where is that? This one. Check for this. Shapiro test. We have AM, dollar sign, NPC. Check. See that? Again, this is less than 0.05. Again, you are going to reject H-null. That means your data is also not normal. See, what I told you, that we need to check first these conditions. So, देखो अगर आप condition आपने model बना लिया, ठीक है? Model बनाने के बाद immediately आप ये दो पहले condition check करो. तो अगर कंडीशन में ही हम पा जाएंगे कि आपका हेटरोस्केडास्टिसिटी एग्जिस्ट है या फिर नॉर्मल असम्पशन सेटिस्फाई नहीं कर रहा, मतलब हम लोग वी कांट मूव अहेड, मींस देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ टेस्टिंग, एक्चुअली इट इज देयर, एक्चुअली इट इज देयर, देन वी गो फॉर डेटा वैलिडेशन पार्ट. अगर डेटा वैलिडेशन will be taught by Jay sir, if you remember. I don't know how much you remember. Have you studied data validation concept something? Yes. कुछ पढ़ा है क्या data validation से related? Means if there is something outlier or something like that. ऐसा कुछ पढ़ा है? I don't know how much you understood here, but this is the way we have to always go. That is called data pre-processing. Data pre-processing. So in data pre-processing, we have these all concepts like detection, then treatment of missing value, right? Different concepts. Then variable selection, etc., etc. Just give me a minute. So you can just go, just you can take some. Yes, any doubt? Any question related to? So I hope you have start writing your practicals. So if you need any help, let me know. I may share that detail. I may share that if you want that particular file, that is MLR file, where you can able to see the question number 4. I may just paste that code for question number 4. Rest conclusion and everything, that output you can just work on, and you can just write that output for that, as we did for remaining problems, okay. And complete it and let me know the. So till next Saturday, you're going to submit this practical. Okay, practical number, I think it is. Which your practical number is that practical. And you have to just submit this MLR practical on next Saturday, till next Saturday. Okay, so finish it and let me know if you have any questions related to the practical. Okay, so I think I have already shared few problems. You need to just copy it. Okay, you need to just copy it and you can upload it. I think the output is also given for the question number 1. Something is missing here. We need to just take care of that. हाँ भेजता हूँ ना, थर्ड टाइम के बाद चलेगा क्या? थर्ड टाइम के बाद भेजता हूँ चलेगा? So I think this is also given. Some model I have not pasted the output, but when you go for like doing the hands-on and you get the output, you paste it here at least for two models and so on. Then you can check for heterospasticity and you can check for normality. So till here you have to do it for question. Even question number two also, I think I have given output. This is the question number two. Question number three. Yeah, there is output. So you need to just understand question number four. Uska output aap likh ke lijiye. Okay? Because all questions are given output. Only the thing is that question number four. Just work on question number four. And you can. Write it down entire thing in your practical. Yes, any question? Let me know. Yes, boliye. No question? सही है, कुछ क्वेश्चन नहीं है तो फिर क्वेश्चन नहीं है तो क्या करेंगे फिर, कुछ कुछ क्वेश्चंस नहीं है तो